Let's review the solve process using the following problem. Kelly has 3 apples and 4 bananas in her cart. How many pieces of fruit does Kelly have in her cart? What do we know about the problem? Kelly has 3 apples and Kelly has 4 bananas in her cart. What do we need to know about the problem? We need to figure out how many pieces of fruit Kelly has in her cart. Record the known and unknown information. Model how to write the solution statement. Kelly has blank pieces of fruit in her cart. Using picture cards and a number bond, represent the problem. What part of the fruit are apples? 3. What part of the fruit are bananas? 4. How can the number bond be used to determine how many pieces of fruit Kelly has in her cart? We can put the fruit together. Part, part, whole. If we use a counting strategy to determine the number of pieces of fruit in Kelly's cart, we would point to the 3 apple picture cards and say 3, and then point at each banana picture card and count on 4, 5, 6, 7. If we use a counting strategy and count on from the greater quantity, we would point to the 4 banana picture cards and say 4, and then point at each apple picture card and count on 5, 6, 7. Ultimately, we can count on from either part and conclude that Kelly has 7 pieces of fruit in her cart. Students will continue to represent and solve part-part-whole word problems using a counting strategy, number bonds, part-part-whole mats, picture cards, or counters. Remember that part-part-whole problems involve situations in which quantities have a relationship. There is no action in part-part-whole situations. Equations with the addition and equal to symbols should not be introduced in this unit. As students work through the solve problem-solving process with part-part-whole word problems, present both the number bond work mat and the part-part-whole work mat and ask students what they notice. They may notice both have white areas for the parts and a shaded or green area for the whole. Both can be used to represent and solve word problems. The number bond has smaller circles for the parts and a larger circle for the whole. The part-part-whole work mat has rectangles for the parts and the whole. We use a chenille stick or line to show how the 2 parts can compose the whole. The same process using solve is recommended for any word problem using a part-part-whole work mat. Continue to emphasize the proportionality of the parts as students partition the mat using a cotton swab or chenille stick in order to develop their sense of number. If Javier has 2 carrots and 6 ears of corn, if students are using a part-part-whole work mat, support the understanding of the carrot part being smaller than the corn part.